Today, I will talk about the Google Assistant. Oh, sorry. My name is Ryan Momonikid. Currently, I work with the Toast Social Overwalk as a product owner, and I am the web GD. Why web GD in the end of my event? Okay, I have an answer for that. Okay. My slide. Okay. I think everyone knows about the Google Assistant, right? You can tap onto your phones, especially Android, for something, even like a weather, traffic, or tell some joke that not joke, okay? Okay, why I'm here? Is Google Assistant is plugged with all the Android. I mean, when you install the Google application, I try to find the good place. Okay, when you install the Google application, or you use Android with the default, is the Google Assistant is already plugged to your phones, and you can use as a assistant to ask the traffic, map, agenda, or play some music from Spotify. I think someone opened the hardware. Okay, Google. Okay, no for it to wait, right? Okay. Google Assistant is chatbot, assistant, AI, whatever. As you want to call, but for me I think we're going to have a problem. But I'm called the conversational platform. I talk about this in this event because the assistant is new platform for the app. As an app developer, you have to understand the new platform and the new way to interact with your user and try to make awesome experience with the Android user. Because in the future, sometimes user will not open the app anymore. Sometimes user will open the app when is user need some complete feature. If not, they just add the Google Assistant, like me. Today, I'm not open to Spotify much. I just say, okay, Google, play some music from Spotify. It's Spotify's play to on my phone. Right now, that thing will be happen in main three platform. One phone, Android, iOS, Google Home, and Android TV. With the new version of the Android TV, will integrate the Google Assistant by default. Google Assistant is not sound, sorry. It's voice and also UI. When Google Assistant launched in the first time, people thought about that it's only sound, is you need to talk with that, you can't like typing anything, but it's not. Right now, Google Assistant supports sound, picture, with the Google links, and also the text. So, the question is, can I have own assistant? That means, if you open the Google Assistant, right now it looks like everything is from the Google, right? One question is, I can add anything, or I can develop some things with my own? Obviously, the answer is yes. If not, I'm not going up to the stairs for today. This is a, we call the directory, but actually it's stole of the Google Assistant. You can build your own app, as it stands, or everything to this, and allow the people across the world to use your assistance, not only on the phone, but in Google Home, that serves some country, but it's not here. But don't worry about that. I think almost people still love to use the phones. First, if you don't want to develop anything, you want only to do their private assistant or just keep that assistant for your friends, you use IFTTT to set up some action and trigger in Google Assistant. Actually, you can open the IFTTT.com and try to set up something like myself, like, okay, Google, mute my phone for my Google Homes. Yes, you can do it with not any coding. But yes, it's hard to integrate with your app. So the Google created a platform called Action on Google to make you integrate the Google Assistant with your application. So I think I should stand up here. Okay. Now you can develop with the three different things. Dialogue for the two that make your life easier. If you're not a guy who like understand what the chatbot or what the natural language processing going on, you use that. You can use a Converse, it's a third party also. It's, I never used it, but I thought it's good. If you're going S1 to the S1, but I'm not recommending, it's using Node.js as a server. Actually, the server is not need to use Node.js, but their official library is Node.js. You just implement, I can say, is normal HTTP. You can write anything, Kotlin, C, Java, anything, just allow their Google Assistant call back to the site, just that. So personally, I recommend Dialogue 4. In the past, that called API.ai. Dialogue 4 is a tool to help you to make an intent. That means question from the user and set up the response like this. You just, okay, I think my secret is wrong with it, not boring. You just train what the word that you want the Google Assistant to capture and what the response. Actually, the response can be from the APIs or can be from the your device response. Now the Dialogue 4 support 18 languages already and include Thai. Actually, I have one thing that Dialogue 4 is very good is Dialogue 4 is not support only Google Assistant, but they offer support Facebook, Slack, Cortana, Telegram, Line, WhatsApp, any chat. So you build one for all. That means you build the chatbot for other platforms, you can build an assistant for the Google Assistant. It's very good. But if you want the more and one that I mentioned, the Google, the action on Google SDK is the way to use that. For me, it's too compact. If I think normal assistant can be covered by Dialogue 4, but it's normal. It's send the answer, send the question, and send to the API or something. Because when you use the action on Google SDK, you have to do the natural language processing. Process by yourself. No option. No any option. You have to dump by yourself. And yeah, Google have some tools for make the assistant understand the language. If that run on actually not the Google SDK, but not good. I prefer to use the PS1. The idea is that Google Home's Android device connect to the action on the Google platform and send the data to the Firebase cloud function for Firebase or Studio Server. If you use Dialog 4, it's built in online data for the cloud function Firebase. You don't need to understand how it works or how to deploy, how to serve. You just write out in the online data and you save it, it's done. So it's very easy if you use the Dialog 4 for that. How do you control the experience of that? How do you control the experience of assistants? It's very, very hard. Because the assistant is a conversational platform. When you are at Google, it's like you chat with someone. Yeah, if you have experience with a chatbot on the Facebook, yeah, you have something like that. But you know, it's a bit different because the Google Assistant does not have only the UI. They still have voice. The concept is too easy that put the text and machine read the text. But when you try to use a Google Assistant, you feel the text reading is feel human. It's like a human reading, right? With the voice, we use SSML. SSML is standard way to make the machine read, follow as anyone. It's called why the subtitle is gone. It's called speech syntax markup language. It looks like this. In the Dialog 4 and also in the action of Google SDK will allow you to type it as a response. You can ask the assistant to say character by interpret as or blank the time before go to the next sentence or put MP3. Call the text as a cardinals or ordinals, put the alias of the text. You do like a markup language, but it makes your voice of the assistant is like a human. More than put the text and let it read. For the UI, only 10 or 14 minutes with half of the slide. So bad. With the UI, you can send simple response like this. Just text. Suggestion? Because sometimes a user, you suggest user for type something, but put the suggestion on the text is not a good way because user have to typing follow your suggestion. So the Google provided some we call ship suggestion that user can click it and done it without any typing. Basic guard show the image and text and link out to some destination. The basic guard is help the user read the rich message easier. List is a straightforward list. You can put the image on the list the tag. Carousel is like a list, but it look more beautiful. One example when you sell the product. You want to put it, the product image, right? And let the user scroll, and click and sell the product, right? Its carousel is the answer. The bouncing carousel think it's the problem. The cursors have a limitation to send out to the link. So they have another thing called a browser carousel that send out to the link. And if that link have an AMP page, it will send link out to the AMP instead of the normal link. So it's something to be careful, but it's okay. Media response. Actually, Google just launched the media response a few months ago that you can send the media, I thought the video did not support. Send the sounds to the Google Assistant, but it's not available in the all that I see is not available in voice mode. In the voice mode, you have to try to make the user understand by themselves. Smart home. If you are the smart home provider, you can have it in your Google Home app. Okay, let's say you open the Google Home app, you will see the section called the home control. When you click it, it have a list of the home control device, right? The long list. You can have it for your product. I think somebody is try to implement own smart home solution or try to make a smart home app. Yeah, you can do it with a smart home. The diagram is quite complex. It's like you have your own server to connect and sync with the home graph, and you as Google try to combine is authentication across the platform, and after that, when your commands from Google Home is using to your server. If you are the guy that is too lazy, I don't want to do anything, but I want an action. You can use a content-based action. If you are the podcast publisher, recipe publisher, new publisher, or audio news publisher, you just put the schema on your site, and within the Google index your site. If your site is able to create as an action in the search control, in the search console, sorry, we show up that hey, your site is available for Google Assistant. We just confirm, and you're going to the directory as a one action. But I try to research and I try to see what the action is from this, but I can't see that. I think it's not available yet in Thailand, but I think it's available in other countries. Daily update and notification. If you are a Google Assistant user, you can ask, okay Google, tell me my day. That thing will be updates on update your agenda, weather, traffic to your office or first meeting, but it's not support for like a third party app yet. So the update and notification will help you to put on that if user allow you. If user allow your app to put on their tell me my name. So right now's update is only support on UI's device. If you are the non-UI device, Google Home will not support this yet. Location and user information. Yeah, the one thing that app need is user information. Right? Sometimes you need to log in, you need to link with another app that exists already. The problem is with sounds, how to sign in. How to sign in with sound? If you use Google Home, it's so easy. It's like Google Home will ask you that, hey, this application need to sign in. Do you allow? You just say yes. It's done. It's so low security, but only one way have it. But in Google Assistant on your phone, is have her the signs that allow to ask you to sign in. But some application will put the sign in on the directory that before you use it, you have to go to the directory to sign in first. Some of the authentication, if used from the Google Home, will ask you to sign on your phone first. You can use it before you sign on your phone. Depends on what information that you want from the user. Also the location. The idea is so when you have an assistant for order the food, try to mention the food. Okay, order the food, blah, blah, blah. You do not need the user speaks long address, right? The Google Homes or Google Assistant is have an option to get the location from the GPS or the home location and send to the provider. You can use it also. In the US, it's Uber use this feature. Domino Pizza use this feature. If you want to use it, you can. If you want to use the location, you can build it also. That stuff is not available in Thailand yet, and no plan for available in Thailand. So, it's a payment. Try to imagine. User asks for buy some stuff, and Google redux the money from the credit card and send to the provider immediately. That's called a payment. The payments, yeah, actually it's pretty straightforward. Its payment is dialogue. The payment is very straightforward. That okay, if in the Google Home that said okay, is Google will charge blah, blah, blah with this amount, and you accept, and you say yes, it's deducting money. And in the Google Assistant on the UI, you have to click and you have to confirm everything first. It's the one thing that should is have to prove in the ready country first. Right now, actually on Google supports 16 languages, include Thai. That means we will have assistant in Thai language soon. If you are the guys want to do the Android app for people, you have to do that for connect the people from other side to your app also. Android, you have a Play Store, right? You have a Play Store for search the app, install the app. Google Assistant have something similar. It's called X-Pro. You can search what the Google Assistant can do, and also in the phone, you can search what the assistant can do. But it's different because you not need to install the assistant on user phone. The way to use this is ask the user, say, talk to, follow your app. Just that. It's done. That's the way to use your assistant from the phone. Right now, they have some application that connect together between app and the assistant, right? Viber, BBM, or WhatsApp. Normally, it's a messaging app. Okay. Developer 2. Okay. If you are nerd guys, want to do some command line stuff for development, you can use it. G-Action CLI. But personally, I use this few times because I don't like it. I always use Dialog 4. They have a simulator for test application in case you don't have a device for test. Actually, I will show you soon. It's a Kotlin and Java. as someone in the GitHub tried to create a exercise APK with the GitHub, with the Kotlin and Java language, you can use this for development. And I say, the language is not a barrier because the assistant will hook, is a use webhook, will hook to the some endpoint and need only the response in the format that assistant understands. So you don't need to worry about the language after Node.js or anything. Yeah, Node.js is very good because it is created by Google, but if you are PhD, if you are the Java guys, you can do the server with Java also. Google Assistant APK. The one thing that is no one talk about it. If you are the device creator, is it device manufacturing, like a speaker, whatever, coffee maker, you can add a Google Assistant to your device. It's very good, right? You just you can have a prototype with Raspberry Pi, and Google Assistant SDK have something called a action on device that not go to the server and back to the device again. It just send the data direct to the device. In the Google I go last year, they do the Juice, I think it's Dream Machine with this, so you can do it with your device also. If you are the UI creator, someone is IoT creator. I thought I saw some white in the top, right? Is time up? 20 minutes? Okay, thank you. Sorry guy, I can't see anything. Okay, we will have an action on Google workshop in Bangkok. Another full time with 21st April, 11 May, 1st June, and 1st July. We will teach you how to do this video for your own.
Okay.
The last one that will motivate you to create the action on Google. This program is called community program of the action on Google. I can't remember the program name. But if you publish action on Google within July, I think so, within July, you get a t-shirt. And if your application is hit some criteria that action on Google set, you will get 200 Monthly Google is just free 200 credit for Google Cloud. So if you want shirt and you want credit, join this program. Okay, I think I still have time, so I will show you how I create action on Google. Actually, I just finished last night, so I have to get my computer first. Okay, this is the dialogue form, first of all. the way to use it is just teaser first. You can set up the default welcome. I set up, okay, yesterday I tried to make an assistant to read the Hacker News. Actually, I want a t-shirt, so I tried to fit it as soon as possible. So I just set up the welcome event and respond from this. When user come to my app, it will say, I am Hacker News reporter, what do you want to know today? And I give them some option, the top story, best stories, or news story. Okay, I will, let's see what's going. When you test the app, you have to, so Google will set up the names of the app is a test app. So, go to my test app. Okay. Is everything done only with dialog force and call function for Firebase? Is the call function for Firebase? I can show the some calls. The should be here. It's just okay. At least that the language is not your family with, but don't worry about that. I just read the API of the Hacker News and make the text and put the bait and send back to the Google Assistant. So you can test with your phone and also you can test with the Google Home at your home. The one thing that I knew that trick last night is if you want to change the name of your test app, you have to use the action of Google SDK that trade off with the difficult way to development, maybe 10 times or 20 times of the dialog form. So, I think I will finish this early. No one will blame me, right? Okay, just as it, we will have another full workshop next month, or in the next 3 months. If you want to do that, if you want to learn how to create your assistant and connect with your Android app, join us, and we will announce or set up the event, everything, and tell you in the Facebook page of us. Thank you so much for today. Thank you so much for the session, but we're not enjoying it. Okay, thank you everyone. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you so much.